Like, subscribe and press the bell icon for more videos from PHN Learn. For more videos, download our app from the Play Store. Hello all, welcome to PHN Technology Private Limited. Today, we are going to study what are format specifiers, what are escape sequences and what are comments. Now, firstly, let's start with what are format specifiers. Now, initially, we have studied that there are data types, and these data types are used to define the type of a particular value, right? Similarly, when you are using these values, that is, you are using these values for input and output operation, and these input and output operations are done in printf and scanf. When you are using these operations in printf and scanf for input and output purposes, you have to again specify what type of these values are, like what integer, float, character, string, etc. Right? So these are known as format specifiers. You have to, whether you are using integer, you have to specify it again to the compiler. See, firstly, while defining the variables or while defining the data types of a value, you have initialized that. That is, for example, int a is equal to 10, semicolon. So this part was the initialization. And now in printf and scanf, what we are doing, we are using that. Right? So again, when you are using that, you have to specify the type. And how can you specify this type? Using the format specifiers. So here you can see all the complete chart of my format specifiers, right? So this is a long list, but among these we use few of them. For example, %d, %f, that is float, %d is used for integer. Again, float is bifurcated into three format specifiers, that is small e, %small e and capital E also. And so for string, %s, for character, %c. Now let's take an example and see. Right. So here is my screen. Again, we used to start hash include header files. I am defining header files. stdio.h. Okay. Then int main. Here, I am defining int a is equal to 10. Okay, again, I am defining a float value, that is int b is equal to 7.564. Any random number, okay? Then printf here. Let's say the value of a is equal to. Now see, we have specified a is an integer. So here, which format specifier we are going to use? That is %d. Okay, because the data type of a is integer. Right. So %d, then comma a. Okay, then semicolon. Let's save it and see, run it. Let's see the output. See, I am getting the value of a is equal to 10. Now see, I have written the %d in double quotes, but still it is not printing the value. Why? Because it's a format specifier. It won't print itself. Okay. It is assigning the a variable that it is a type of integer. And see the %. What the % plays a role is, person gives the memory, person sign assign the memory, that how many memory will it take, that how many memory will a take in my memory. Okay, so for example, if there are not many bytes, there are not enough bytes, so it will replace those empty bytes by using spaces over there. Okay, we will see that example now. See, again I will copy this, and here I want to print the float value, that is b value. And for float we are going to use small f, small e or capital E. Okay, these are the format specifier of the float data type. Okay, f, and here b. Save it, let's run it. See, here the value of a is equal to 10, and then the value of b is equal to this. Now see, what is happening, that I have given float value as 7.564, but still it is occupying some of the bits by again 3 zeros. And this is what I was talking, right? It is occupying because those spaces are left out, so it is occupying by 0000. Okay. Now, for example, let's comment this integer out. Now, you have seen that using the float format specifier float one, we have used 0.2, 0.4. So, why these 0.2, 0.4? So let's first run this out. See, now initially I have my value as 7.564, but it is printing as 7.56 only. Why? Because here in the printf statement I have given 0.2, that is after decimal point I want only two values. Okay, this is the meaning of that. Okay, similarly, if I want, let's say, here I write 4.2. Now, what will it give? Let's see. Nothing. Why? Because see, from 6, if you are calculating, 6, 5, 7. How many characters, numbers are there? How many characters are there? That is 4. Right, so if I'm giving 4 in front of the decimal point, then it will see how many digits are there, and if the digits are exceeding the number, then it will print some spaces over there. Right, so let's see here, 6. Now see here I am getting space over here, and that space is occupying two digits value, right? Why it is so? Because I have only 4. Dot is also considered as a character, right? So here I initially have 4 characters, but what I have given 6 characters, so that is not possible because I don't have 6. So how will I display it, right? So here what is doing, it is occupying those two missing digits by spaces. And this is the work of the percentage. It assigns the memory. Okay. Again, let's see if I given 11. Okay. Here, let's say I have written this. Okay. So you will get how many spaces are there. Let's run this. See, after this many are my spaces. Okay, so again, if I have given here minus 11, then what? Now it will what? Now see, let's run this code. See, now what is it giving? It is giving spaces after the decimal point. Why? Because we have added the minus over there. Okay, so for your convenience, let's add here this. Okay, again, so you will get a proper idea over here. See, spaces over there. Okay, that is after, because I am added in a minus here, that therefore these many spaces. So this was your format specifier. Similarly, you can work with character, for that is percent C, then string, percent S. Okay, now let's move on to escape sequences. Now, what are these escape sequences? Now, see, when you are writing the code, these escape sequences are nothing but it doesn't print itself. That is, it is written in the double quotes again, like the format specifies, but it doesn't print itself. What does it does? That it helps to do some operations, or it helps to get another character to be printed over there. Now let's see in detail what I have told just now in the definition. Now firstly, these are my escape sequences. These many are the list of that. These are many of them, but among these we only use that new line, then double quotes, single quotes, then tab, and so on. So let's see an example. Okay, again, let's come and just delete this out. Okay, again, let's write printf. The value of A is equal to person D. Okay, now here again I will write, let's copy this and paste it. Let it be, here I have forgotten to write return 0, right? Yeah. Now see, let's print this out first. Okay, now see, I'm giving both of the, I have written, say, in the code, concentrate here, because I have written in the code that is printf below each other, right? But in when I'm working with the output console, I'm getting it horizontally, right? One after the other. Why is it so? Because I have not added any escape sequence. That is, here I will add a new line escape sequence. That is slash n. Okay. So let's see here. In the starting I want, right? So in the starting only slash backslash. Okay. Not front slash. Backslash n. Save it, then run it. Now see, as you can see in the output here, now what is it is printing one below each other. So this is the work of escape sequence. Now again, I have written the escape sequence between the quotes, right? But it is not getting printed. It is performing an operation. Okay. Now similarly, if I want tab over here, so you all know what are tab spaces. When we click on tab, there comes a small amount of, similarly, when we click on space, we get space. Similarly, tab also, we get spaces here. So I have used three tabs. Okay. Tab is used by slash backslash T. Okay. Now let's run this out first. Now see, I have given three tabs. See, if you can see, there are small arrows over there, 1, 2 and 3. Why? Because I have given small 3 tabs. So it has given tab spaces. Okay, now these are the your escape sequence. Now, similarly, it goes with the percent backslash also. That is percent B also. Backspace means it will delete the previous letter. Okay, backspace. Now, if just imagine, if you want, you have a printf statement. Okay, let's see over here. Comment this. Okay, now here I want to have, let's say this is PHN. Technology. Okay, I have written a string over here and I have saved it, right? Now what I want is, I want my PHN technology, I want my PHN technology between the two quotes, right? So now what will you do? Because between the two quotes, that is, I have written the printf statement into the double quotes, right? Now inside that code, I similarly, like a, let's say if I've written a quote over here, like single quote. So run it. see. Here, I have given single quote, so it is working. Okay. Now, if you want to do this using an escape sequence, then again you have to add here a backslash. Here a backslash. Okay. Let's complete this whole PHN technology in between the quotes. Okay. Save it, then run it. See. Again, I'm getting PHN technology. Okay. So, what I have done here, I've used the escape sequence over here. Right? If you are going to use escape sequence, this if you want to identify that, then just see the backslash over here. If you are getting a backslash over there, then it is an escape sequence. That is the identification of it. Okay. So here I can again use a double quote over there. Right. What will I do? Backslash, double quote, PHN technology, again close it. Backslash, double quote. So this was your escape sequences. Okay, now comments. Now see, everybody in coding, while learning the programming language, you may think that comments are not very much essential, right? But what happens in the coding world is that it is comments, giving comments to every statement of your code is a good sign of a programmer, right? Why? Because you can, after now we are working with only 10 lines of code, right? But in the future, if you are going to make a project, you will be working with thousands and thousands lines of codes. At that time, let's say for example, you have given the integer A, and similarly till Z you have given these many integers, that is int A is equal to, int B is equal to, and so on till Z. And whole these 26 variables you have used in your code also. Now, how will you understand that A, that is integer A, this value is for my this and B is for my this work? It will definitely become tedious, right? How will you understand that A is for my plusing point, B is for my subtraction, and so on? How will you understand that which variable is assigned to which work, right? So here what will you do? You have to give comment over there, right? If you have given comment, then just you have to scroll, see that comment that A is used for this, and you can make changes in your code as per the given comment, right? So for this purpose, comments are used. And again, comments are also used for that you don't have to remove your code. So for example, if you are testing your code, right? So you have to change your code many times and see if it is working or not. So you don't have, if you comment some code, then you don't have to again and again change the code or delete the code and then copy paste it then again. Those are some tedious process, right? So if you comment it, it will stay in your code, but it will be ignored by the compiler, right? So let's see over here. See, here I have already used a single line comment. Okay, when you want to comment only a line, that is only single line, then you have to use double slash. Okay, double slash. Now see, the moment I have given double slash over here, it is become green color. And now let me remove it. See, again it is in the code now. It is not ignored, right? Because I have removed the comments over there. Again, I have given the comments. Save it. See. So this was your single line comment. Now I want to comment this whole part. These are my multiple lines, right? So how will I comment this? See. Save it. So this, through this, I am giving a multiple line comment. That is slash star starting point of the comment, and then again star slash. Okay, that is the ending point. So this was your comments. So every time remember that comments are not the easiest part. You need to remember this and you need to apply this in your code. Okay, the comments, using comments frequently is a sign of a good programmer, right? So this was today's session. Okay, let's meet up in the next session, and thank you and goodbye.
For more videos, download our app on the Play Store.